हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द चैनल इग्नू डीएनएचई ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर आयुषी. वी आर स्टडिंग डीएनएचई 1. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड 7 यूनिट्स एंड नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ यूनिट 8, मील प्लानिंग फॉर प्रेग्नेंट एंड लैक्टेटिंग वुमेन. व्हाट वी विल स्टडी टुडे? इंट्रोडक्शन, प्रेगनेंसी, आरडीए एंड मील प्लानिंग फॉर प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन, लैक्टेशन, RDA and meal planning for lactating women, and at last, questions of this unit. Introduction. In previous unit, we studied adulthood. It represents a stable state in life. That is, growth in terms of body size has been completed. The nutrient need is for maintenance rather than for growth. But in the life of an adult woman, there may be two phases, that is pregnancy and lactation. When there are sharp increases in nutrient requirement, pregnancy is the period in the life of an adult woman when the fetus grows inside her body. To support this growth of the fetus, certain physiological changes take place in the woman's body. So, these changes along with growth of the fetus necessitate an increase in the nutrient requirements of the woman. Lactation is the period following the birth of the child when the mother breastfeeds her baby. The baby for the first few months after birth depends totally on breast milk for nourishment. Hence, more food is required by the woman during lactation to help meet the additional nutrient requirements. Pregnancy. Pregnancy is a period of about 9 months. It is the period when the fetus grows inside the woman's body. Life for human beings begins with fusion of two cells, the egg from the mother and sperm from the father. Inside the woman's body, they unite to form a single cell. This tiny single cell migrates to the uterus and there grows to form the fetus. This single cell divide into two cells, then 4, 8 and many such cells. As a result, there is a tremendous increase in cell number and cell size also increases. Gradually, cells become specialized in structure and function. Similar type of cells align themselves to form tissue. These tissues then form the organs of the body. Growth and development of these organs continues. In a period of about 270 days or 40 weeks, the fetus grows from being a single cell to weight of almost 2.5 to 3 kg. A fetus grows and develops very rapidly and takes all the nutrients required for growth and development from the mother's body. This takes place with help of placenta. Placenta is a spongy tissue which develops in the uterus only during pregnancy. The fetus is attached to the mother through the umbilical cord, which is attached to placenta. Within the placenta, oxygen, nutrients, and waste products are exchanged between mother's blood and that of the fetus. Next is physiological changes during pregnancy. First is change in body organs, like development of placenta, increase in size of uterus and its supporting muscles, in order to accommodate the growing fetus. Breast grows in size and prepares to produce milk. Second is changes in body metabolism. BMR increases during pregnancy due to rapid growth and development of fetus and mother's tissue. Third is changes in body fluids. Total fluid increases. Blood increases in volume about 50% and due to this, concentration of hemoglobin and other blood cells reduces. The normal hemoglobin level of 12 mg per 100 ml of blood drops to 10 to 11 mg per 100 ml during pregnancy. Next is changes in digestive functioning. To meet the increased demand, calcium and iron absorption increases. Next, there is less production and secretion of acid and other digestive juices. Therefore, the food is not broken down and digested properly. This tends to stay in the stomach for a longer time, and that gives a feeling of heaviness and fullness. Due to growing fetus, the capacity of stomach and speed of the digestion tend to decrease, leading to nausea, vomiting, heartburn, and other symptoms for indigestion in early pregnancy. The movement of food in digestive tract becomes slow and sluggish as the muscle activity is altered, and constipation occurs, which is common at the end of the pregnancy period. Last is changes in the body weight. During pregnancy, a woman gains weight. This weight gain is due to growing fetus, increase in the size of the uterus, development of the placenta, increase in breast size, increase in blood and total body fluids, and deposition of fat in the body. Now, it's a question that how much weight gain is normal? It is expected a total gain of 8 to 10 kg gain to her pre-pregnancy weight. The entire pregnancy period is divided into three trimesters. First is 0 to 3 months, second is 3 to 6 months, and third trimester is 6 to 9 months. It is observed that the maximum weight gain occurs only during second and third trimester, because maximum growth of fetus and maternal tissues takes place during these months. Therefore, weight gain is considered the best indicator of a successful pregnancy, and progressive weight gain indicates that the fetus and mother's tissue are growing normally. Gain in weight less than 8 kg is indicative of poor health of fetus and woman. If a woman does not have proper weight gain, she may give birth to an underweight baby who would have little or no chance of survival, and the life of the woman could also be endangered. So, the effort should be achieved to satisfy weight gain during pregnancy. Excess weight gain is also not advisable, as this too adversely affects the health of fetus and woman. Next is RDA for pregnant woman. ICMR has fixed values of RDA according to age, sex, and activity level. And in addition to this, they have fixed RDAs for pregnant and lactating women. This is the chart of RDA for pregnant women. This is an old one. Always try to be updated and search for the latest updates. I have a latest chart of 2020. If you want, you can ask for it and I will provide you that. In this table, you would notice that RDAs for energy, protein and B vitamins are given in terms of additional intakes. That is, they are indicated by the plus sign, and for other nutrients as total intake figure. A woman during pregnancy requires 350 calories and 23 gram protein in addition to what she needs when non-pregnant. Let's see, taking example of a sedentary woman during pregnancy would require a total of 2250 calories, that is 900 plus 350, and total of 78 gram protein, that is 55 plus 23. Physically active pregnant women and pregnant adolescent girls, that is girls between 13 to 18 years of age who are pregnant, would require more as compared to sedentary pregnant women. Pregnant adolescent girls would need more nutrients to support their own growth as well as for the growing fetus. The requirement of B vitamins like thiamine, riboflavin, and niacin is based on the energy requirement. The greater the energy need, the higher would be the B vitamin needs. The RDAs for almost all the nutrients increases during pregnancy, but the requirement of few specific nutrients increases substantially. These nutrients are energy, protein, calcium, and iron. Besides iron, the other two trace elements, that is iodine and zinc, also are of vital importance during pregnancy. So, firstly, let's see why there is a need for extra energy. It is required to support the growth of fetus and placenta, add to fat reserves of mother, and to compensate for increased energy expenditure due to higher BMR. Second is, need for protein is more as this nutrient is required for synthesis of new tissues in both mother and fetus. Next is, iron is needed for the synthesis of hemoglobin in the fetal blood cells. And in addition to this, fetus accumulates abundant stores of iron in body to last through the first 3 to 6 months of life after birth. Next is calcium. Its need increases to support the mineralization of bones and teeth in the fetus. Next one is zinc. Zinc is required for growth and protein synthesis. And iodine helps to regulate the physical and mental growth of the fetus. Must remember that the requirement for most nutrients increase only from second trimester onwards. The fetus obtains all nutrients required for its growth from the mother's diet. If the diet is inadequate, the mother's tissue will be broken down to supply these nutrients to the fetus. So, it becomes important here to note that a well-nourished woman with adequate nutrient reserves will be better equipped for a successful pregnancy. Next topic is meal planning for pregnant women. During meal planning for an individual of any age group, sex, or activity level, always consider these basic four factors during meal planning. These are nutritional adequacy, availability of food, acceptability and income of an individual. Next is, for whom are we planning for? Look for, is the woman is first or second or third trimester of pregnancy? What is the income level? Does she belongs to high, middle or low income group? Third is, which region does she belong to? This information will help you specify the kind and amount of food to be selected. Next is, which nutrients are of particular importance? We have already learned about them. These are energy-giving nutrients, that is carbohydrates and fats, proteins, calcium and iron. But remember that the requirement of these nutrients increases only from the second trimester onwards. Next is, which food to select. Diet must include food items from each of the three major food groups to help meet the requirements. The requirement of energy, protein, calcium, and iron is maximum during pregnancy. Diet must include cereals, pulses, milk and milk products, and green leafy vegetables. If acceptable, you can include meat, fish, poultry, and egg. If income permits, nuts and oil seeds may be considered. For your reference, a list of food items rich in energy, protein, calcium, and iron is given in Annexure 1 at the end of the block. Iron from food sources is not sufficient to meet the increased needs of iron during pregnancy. Additional iron in the form of tablets usually needs to be given. It is suggested that right from second trimester onwards, a pregnant woman should take an iron tablet providing 100 mg iron and 500 microgram folic acid daily. These tablets are available free of cost at ICDS and Anganwadis, or one could also buy them from market at a minimal cost. Another important point is use of iodized salt for cooking will help to meet the iodine need during pregnancy. Next is, are there any special food preparation for the pregnant woman? You must have observed that mothers or mother-in-law preparing and serving special food items to their pregnant daughter or daughter-in-law. For example, in North India, panjiri is commonly served. In South India, payasam, and in West, methi pak is commonly served. These special food preparations are energy and protein-rich snacks made of cereals, pulses, fats, nuts, and special herbs. In addition to calories and proteins, they provide sufficient amounts of other essential nutrients like calcium, iron, or vitamin A. They help to meet the increased needs during pregnancy. Some of the common traditional food preparations of different regions are listed for your reference in Annexure 2. What should be the meal pattern? To meet the increased demands during pregnancy, it is required to increase the food intake. To begin with, try to increase the amount of food normally eaten at each meal, like by increasing the number of chapatis or amount of rice, dal or vegetables normally consumed. But it is generally seen that pregnant women cannot eat much at one time because of various digestive changes. Alternative to this is to provide small but frequent meals. Let's see the following list. Group A. It includes breakfast, mid-morning meal, lunch, tea, and dinner. This is 4 to 5 meals per day pattern and is likely to be followed by a low-income group pregnant woman. Group B. It includes breakfast, mid-morning meal, lunch, mid-afternoon meal, tea, and dinner. It is a 5 to 6 meals per day pattern and is likely to be followed by a middle-income group pregnant woman. Last is Group C. It includes bed tea, breakfast, mid-morning meal, lunch, mid-afternoon meal, tea, dinner, and bedtime. This is a 6 to 7 meals per day pattern and is typical of high-income group. Remember, whatever be the income group, the idea is to provide small but frequent meals during pregnancy. Next is, what are the other specific considerations? To overcome morning sickness or early morning nausea and vomiting, the woman should be provided with carbohydrate-rich foods or foods like biscuit, rusk, or bread early in the morning. Next is, to overcome heartburn or feeling of heaviness or fullness, fatty and fried food should be restricted and one should eat small and frequent meals. To prevent constipation, one should take plenty of fiber-rich foods and adequate amounts of fluid in the diet. Water and other drinks such as milk, buttermilk, coconut water, lime juice, etc. should be taken in between meals to help movement of food through the digestive tract and thus preventing constipation. Simple tips on how to ensure a safe, comfortable pregnancy are listed in points to remember in book. Second part of this unit is lactation. Lactation is the period following pregnancy when the woman nourishes a fully developed and a rapidly growing baby with breast milk. Breast milk contains most of the nutrients that are required by the baby. A lactating woman secretes about 500 ml of milk per day in first month and about 1 liter of milk per day by the fifth month. On an average, a well-nourished lactating woman secretes about 850 ml milk per day. Nutrient composition of milk secreted is this. Go through the chart. All these nutrients contained in breast milk are derived from the mother's body. Therefore, lactation makes considerable nutritional demands on the woman and imposes great strain on the woman, even more than in pregnancy. This is a very important point to remember. The mother's diet and state of nutrition influence the composition and output of milk produced. Extra nutrient should be provided during lactation so as to help the mother secrete enough milk and maintain adequate level of nutrients. RDA for lactating women. Here, again, the energy, protein and B vitamins are represented with plus sign. The nutrient requirements increase considerably during lactation. In this table, you will notice that RDAs are given for two stages, that is 0 to 6 months and 6 to 12 months of lactation. The nutrient need during first 6 months is much higher than 6 to 12 month stage. This is so because during first 6 months, the amount of milk secreted is the most. But 6 months later, lactation reaches its peak and therefore the milk output starts decreasing gradually and so does the nutrient need. If we calculate the figures, we will find that there is 27 to 31% increase in energy needs. While deciding on energy requirement, always keep in mind the activity level of the lactating woman should be considered. In addition to energy, the need for proteins, calcium, vitamin A and C is considerably high during lactation. The growing infant needs sufficient amount of bodybuilding and protective nutrients for rapid growth of tissues. The infant takes all these nutrients from mother's milk. Hence, the diet of the lactating woman should contain plenty of these nutrients. Next is meal planning for the lactating woman. The mother's nutrition is a key to successful breastfeeding and therefore the baby's health. With increased nutrient need during lactation, the woman needs to eat more food, in fact, more than during pregnancy. Consider the basic four focal points, that is, nutritional adequacy, availability of food, acceptability of food, and income of the individual. Next is, for whom are we planning for? Is the woman in the first 6 months of lactation or is she in 6 to 12 month stage? Which income group does she belongs to? Low, middle or high? And where does the woman live? Based on this information, first list the nutrient requirement and then decide on the right kind of foods to be included in the meals. Which nutrients are of particular importance? In general, the requirement of all the nutrients increases during lactation, but the diet should provide specifically more of the following: energy giving nutrients, proteins, calcium, vitamin A and vitamin C. The requirement for energy and protein during the first 6 months of lactation is comparatively more than the next 6 months. So, while planning, one should also take this aspect into consideration. Which foods to select? Provide an adequate, well-balanced meal during lactation and include at least one food item from each of the three food groups. Particularly, requirement of energy, protein, calcium, vitamin A and C is high during lactation. If we talk about food items, the woman should be provided with mixture of cereals, pulses and meat or fish or egg, milk and milk products, green leafy vegetables, other vegetables, especially yellow or orange colored vegetables, seasonal fruits and nuts or oil seeds. Next is, what should be the meal pattern? To meet the increased nutrient requirements, the lactating woman needs to increase the amount of food normally eaten in a day. To begin with, she should continue to eat the same balanced diet that was eaten during pregnancy. And in addition, certain snacks or food preparations should be served at different times of the day, that is, mid-morning, mid-afternoon, or tea time. This will help to meet the increased nutrient requirement. The number of meals consumed in a day should be increased during lactation. A 5-6 meal pattern can be followed, including breakfast, mid-morning meal, lunch, mid-afternoon meal, tea and dinner. What are the other specific considerations? First is, along with increased food intake, the fluid intake should also be increased during lactation, because this helps in maintaining an adequate supply of breast milk. Plenty of water and liquids in the form of juices, tea, milk, lime juice, coconut water should be provided. Next is, during lactation, no specific food needs to be omitted from the diet until and unless if she suspects a particular food is causing some discomfort to the infant. She can eliminate that food from her diet. A lactating mother can eat whatever nutritious food she chooses. Another important point is that food with strong or specific flavor may alter the taste of breast milk. So, use of such foods should be restricted. Another very important thing. During lactation, substances like alcohol, drugs, etc. should be avoided, because they can enter the breast milk and interfere with infant development. Drugs should be taken only in consultation with the doctor. So, this is all about this unit. These are questions from the first part of the unit, that is pregnancy. And these are questions from the second part, that is lactation. Students ask me for important questions. I would recommend all of you to go through the previous year's question papers and check your progress exercises. If you study these questions, you will easily pass the exams and will score good marks. In the next video, we will start with next unit, that is Unit 9, Meal Planning for Infants and Preschoolers.